Dudes rock.
I've said it before on the show, but the funniest thing I ever saw in the train station, I forget what platform I was on, but you know how they have like those like blocks?
Yeah.
That divide. I walked to the end of the platform and I went behind a block. And there was a guy just completely naked.
Hell yeah.
And he was just dude. Just sort of like just standing there. Just turn around and went back.
That's awesome.
No clothes on.
Not dick out. Pure, not wearing a stitch of clothing.
Just completely naked, hidden at the end of the platform. Like a glitch. Like just like the store, the data model of what a person looks like.
Greatest city in the world, man.
Yeah. And I ripped one of my shirts. I have not destroyed any pair of Mack Weldon stuff.
That's awesome.
All my other clothes are destroyed.
Yeah.
And people close to me don't speak to me anymore and stuff. But the Mack Weldon loyalty program, becoming a level one member is as easy as making a purchase with an account. After that, you'll never pay for shipping again.
Never.
And level two.
I love being in the program.
I love being in the zone.
Mm-hmm. The auto zone.
The discovery zone.
Get in the zone.
Discovery zone.
Discovery zone.
Get your child ass in the zone now.
I love discovery zone.
It's very, very sort of a...
Going to DZ.
The name is a little... Did your family ever take you to a place called Chunky Cheeks?
No.
Okay.
Before you ask,
you sure
no.
They didn't take you?
No.
It looks like
so
they
check
did.
This out. Level one, make a purchase with an account. Level two, spend $200 with an account within one membership year, and you get the diamond.
Oh, it's
in
defunct.
Columns.
Discovery Zone.
Yeah, for years.
2001?
Yeah, dude. 20 years
what?
Ago. I remember
so
I was trying
up.
To go as a 29-year-old.
Well, wait a second. In Cincinnati,
mm-hmm.
In Union Township, Ohio, there's something called Discovery Zone that's not affiliated with the original company, but is heavily inspired by it.
Wow.
This is owned by Italians. Yeah, it's Discovery Zone.
Discovery
we
Zone.
We also own a Chunky Cheeks, which is like, it's the same kind of thing, but the tubes are wider.
that would have been good.
They got wide tubes
you
for,
get
the, bigger,
stuck in a tube
for the fatter ever? Boys.
No.
You never got stuck in a tube?
I've never got stuck in a tube.
Just another child going into the ball pit, and all the balls are like discs. They're all flat. And then Stav's just sitting on a bunch of flat discs. He's like, it was a disc pit.
It was broken when I got
it's
here.
It's a disc pit. It was always a disc pit.
I missed
now,
DZ.
If you'll excuse me, I'm waiting for the fire department to get here so I can
so I can eat pizza and play the Simpsons game. So I can thank you very much.
So I can exit from the tube from whence I came.
I'm waiting for either the fire department or them to get a big thing of Crisco to loop me up. Either, whichever's here faster.
Yeah, it's always what was that the Simpsons episode where Homer gets stuck on the slide?
I don't remember.
You know, all we do together is go to lunch,
which is a great. Nice thing.
I hate doing shit.
I love going to lunch.
I like doing stuff.
I like having my joke around friends that I see at work only, and then having my serious friends.
Right. No joke.
Yeah, I hang out with a bunch of neurosurgeons.
Yeah. Scientists.
And we
a
have
lot
dinner.
Of snobs.
We have very quiet dinner parties, and I would say, Richard, my inquiry to you last week, did you get a chance to take a look at any of that research? And they're like, you mean the email asking me if you could implant gay memories into someone's brain with a baguette? Or do baguettes cause gay thoughts?
Mm-hmm. Do they?
No, if there's no reason.
Is there research on that?
That's interesting. I beg to differ. I think it was a bag. I mean, I think theoretically a bad guy could do that.
I suppose, in my estimation, it could.
Maybe there's just a lack of, it's as with everything, a lack of funding for the research, I would say. No, I don't think it's a... I don't think there's any mechanism by which eating a baguette could make you gay for 20 minutes or whatever you said.
20 minutes a month if you eat a baguette, you get to be gay?
Danielle.
And it's not your fault.
And the email I sent you, the Go-Gurt in your ass saying this. That's not a medical question.
We cannot sew your balls into your ass and make it a fridge.
I don't know what an intercooler is. And no. I just like the intellectual curiosity.
I'm asking questions.
I'm asking questions.
I'm trying to be an intellectual provocateur.
I subscribe to National Geographic magazine. I am an intellectual, after all. I voted for Bernie Sanders, and prior to that, I was more of like an Adult Swim kind of guy. And then after voting for Bernie Sanders, I realized I'm an intellectual, and I immediately subscribed to National Geographic magazine and started asking questions such as, whose fault is it that I'm a loser?
Yeah. Is it because I eat baguettes I think gay shit?
Yeah, because obviously I'm a genius of some sort.
Obviously I'm a straight genius.
Mm-hmm. Well, all of these esoteric concepts I can easily repeat.
So it's more like, it's like a salon, you and your friends.
Yeah.
You guys are just thinking of like, you bring different like highfalutin things to a meeting and then you present them to one another. Yeah,
and don't think that I don't.
Who do you have in the crew?
Just a couple of neurosurgeons and then some bitch named Danielle.
Really? What's she like? What's her vibe?
She's hot.
She had big tits.
She's hot. One of these days I'm gonna fuck her.
Oh, not yet.
Once I get the other doctors to convince her I'm not gay through science, and I get her to trust the science,
right?
Then it's over for that.
It's over for that bitch's pussy.
Have any of the doctors fucked Danielle?
R.I.P. Danielle's pussy.
Boom. Fucking on site.
Watch. She doesn't think I'm gay. It's done for her.
She's got nothing.
No chance, bitch. That's the only thing keeping me at bay is you thinking I'm gay. That little blockade is lifted.
Yeah.
Yep.
I wish I could get genetic modification to have long, just thick whiskers.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be sick.
Just like, but they're like hard, you know?
But can you use them to like feel out stuff? Because don't they use their whiskers to like...
Yeah, yeah.
Because they're always doing that shit.
Yeah, I would do it, but they would pick up like chemicals or something.
Oh, that's
or,
cool. Pussy scent.
That's sick.
You could know if there's good pussy around.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That would be awesome.
Yeah.
If you could, I wonder if good pussy scientifically smells different.
I honestly, I would love to be a giant rat with like fucked up ears, like just chewed up ears.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like big floppy chewed up ears, and I'm just a huge rat.
Rats? How big? Like human size?
The size I am now.
But you're a rat.
But I'm a rat.
Proportional.
Big
I hate
that.
Snout,
I would kill you so
big
fast.
Big lumpy snout.
That's
like
disgusting.
A red nose on the end and big whiskers.
I would call the police.
A big just chewed up ears with like a piercing on the end.
A piercing,
a little ring.
So you're a gay rat too?
No, I mean it would just be that. No, I didn't choose that. It's a from the laboratory.
Oh, I see.
You escaped. They tagged you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, man. That sounds disgusting.
Yeah, rats are really cool.
No,
I don't want to chill with them, but they can do a lot of shit. They can hold their breath underwater for like 3 hours.
There definitely is a type of girl that loves rats.
I don't think they can. I don't think they can hold their breath underwater for 3 hours.
I'm pretty sure they can.
3 hours?
Maybe I made that up.
There's no way that's true.
I think I probably just
there's there is absolutely
3 hours is so long.
They're mammals. They're rodents.
3 hours is so long.
There's no way a whale can't even do that.
But a fish can.
What I like too is there's going to be people that do that for the rest of their lives now, but like at their job at GameStop. And they're like, I'm like the guy on the show. I'm like, Mia, I'm like Stave Rose and Alan and Nate.
I'm like Nate Mullins.
I'm like Nate Mookie and Stimrose Hollabad and Aaron Jewish. They're my heroes. I'm just kidding. They're not my heroes. I'm better than them somehow. But I sit and listen to their show every day and repeat the things they say. Ha ha ha. They're so gay and stupid.
Not me, though. I'm a perfectly normal guy.
Elmer Fudd, is that you?
Yeah, it's me, Elmer Fudd.